Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the fourth part of my Great Wall Hobby 148th scale Mig-29 Fulcrum build. Right, so we have put together the kit and we are almost ready to start painting. But before that, I need to paint and close the canopy. Whenever possible, I try to fix the canopy temporarily during painting, rather than masking the cockpit. The kit comes with this interesting photo edge gun sight. Just a word of caution, the gun sight is slightly bigger than needed, so you may have to trim it, or else there may be problems while closing the canopy. Now to mask the canopy. I have become partial to using a thin masking tape for the canopy. Two reasons. Firstly, the edge is really clean and sharp, as it is factory cut. Secondly, I am avoiding running my knife over the canopy to cut the mask. This reduces the chances of accidentally scratching the canopy. For the curved edges, I am using a bendable masking tape. Finally, the canopy is covered with a masking fluid. Small gaps that were too intricate to be masked with tape are covered with a masking fluid which is pushed in place with a cocktail stick. The larger canopy is also masked the same way. However, the inside also needs to be masked. Once again, the narrow masking tape comes in very handy. With the canopy now masked, I can glue the gun sight in place. Next, I carefully mask the exhausts. A wet tissue is used to mask the wheel wells. I now give the kit a good cleanup with a paper towel dipped in alcohol. I start the painting with the canopy, which needs to be painted on the inside. I use the same gray that I used for the cockpit. While the front half of the canopy has been glued in, the rear half has just been clicked in place. A very nice fit allowed me to do this. I now paint the same gray on the outside of the canopy as well. The first thing to be sprayed on is a black base. The kit is rather large, so I had to paint in sections, starting from the top. Once the paint on top was dry, I did the belly. I now use some white paint to marble the kit, once again moving section by section. With the marbling done, I start the main camo scheme. I will be using this set from Ammo by Mig. The first color is medium gunship grey for the nose cone and a few panels. Once the paint was dry, I masked off these sections and applied the second color, light compass grey, starting with the underside. The anti-glare panels are painted with black. Some more masking on the anti-glare panels, and I continue with the light compass gray, freehanding the camo pattern. Time now for the green. I use a couple of pieces of cardboard to ensure that the green does not spill over to the compass gray panels. I go back with the compass gray to clean up areas that I thought needed a bit of a touch-up. Now a coat of Mr. Super Clear Gloss. Again, a word of caution. While using these cans, use very thin bursts of spray. A little too much and the gloss varnish can easily flood the surface, leaving ugly pools, which in fact did happen to me and required sanding and repainting. You must have also noticed that I have now switched to my 3-sponge patented rig technique. I find this to be the best way to support a large kit without scratching it or having to buy an expensive support rig. Once the varnish was dry, I started off with the stencils and the decals, of which there were only a million. It took me a whole day to fix these in place using Microsol. Right then, fellow model makers, we are ready to start with weathering this kit. However, that will have to wait till the next edition. I hope you liked the video. Please do leave a like and subscribe to the channel. Don't forget to hit the bell icon to keep updated with all my uploads. Till next time, good luck and happy model making!